you have seen what's going on around social media. And one thing I want to say is betting is a disease. Most people don't look at it that way. Mimiling pattern. And I'm so glad that I have so many guys who are willing to help me. I just want to say thank you to Jinika Foundation and Pakamia because they're going to help me through this. And then hopefully afterwards I can give my story and I can become like a brand ambassador for responsible betting guys. So yeah, I just want to say thank you and I hope all goes well. That is what we worked on. We realized a lot about my past, a lot about things that were going on in my childhood that maybe I hadn't worked on. So now it's just unraveling the story for the poly, and then Doc also is giving me a few like things that I can do when I feel the urge to, you know, gamble. I can call her anytime. Yeah, so I feel like it's baby steps and we're gonna get there.
Okay, and maybe I have a question for you, Baha. When did you realize that things went overboard, that you needed help?
Wow, funny thing, I did. That's the weird point. You don't realize yourself. Maybe get away when you realize and I'm going to stop continuing too far gone. So for me, I hadn't realized. Happened, it pushed me to towards doing things that I wasn't really, really proud of. And yeah, so now I'm here and I'm working on myself.
Okay, so but just in case. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you. Right. Oh, it's been a pleasure, guys.
I'm the founder of Jinika Foundation. It's an organization I founded after one of my friends succumbed to gaming. Actually, he committed suicide. That's when I got a drive to start the foundation. What we've been doing, we have a website and a toll-free number. We've been receiving numerous calls. Actually, it's very overwhelming, the number of calls we are receiving with people who have problem gaming. Can I call the key players in the industry and everyone else, including government agencies, to help in curbing this problem? It's becoming quite a big problem, and the issue is most of the people who are facing the issue problem gaming are not speaking out. Baha is one in thousands, and I hope those who have this issue can come out, and we hope that the key players in the industry will help in this drive as we try and make sure that gaming is taken as making investments. So thank you, Pakamia, for supporting this initiative, and we hope other key players will come in, and ourselves will do all we can to make sure that we regulate the issue of problem gaming. Thanks.
Hello. My name is Sylvia Raiway. I'm a clinical psychologist. So when Jinika Foundation and Pakamia got in touch with me to see Robert, they wanted him to go through assessments, at least to see if there's an issue that maybe he's dealing with. And that is what we've been doing so far. I wanted to explain something. He said that betting is a problem. I want to explain the fact that there are three kind of gamblers. Let me use the word gamblers. So there is a professional one who's very okay in terms of what they do. They know what resources they can put into gambling, or they know how to do it and they know how to tame themselves. And then there is a social gambler who does it for fun, where most Kenyans are. And then now we have the problem gambler, who now is an addicted gambler. That's where now the problem comes in. So what happens in this case, I'm just trying to say, not everyone who does betting has a problem, but if you do have an addiction whereby you cannot control the amount of money, if you do have an issue in managing the time you spend in betting and all that, then you need to seek help. And that's what Robert is doing right now. And most of the people who have gambling addiction have underlying issues as well. underlying psychopathologies sometimes. Maybe there is depression, maybe there is bipolar, because it's an impulse control disorder. So if there is anyone that you know out there who's having a problem with like kidneys, he or she needs to be seen by a doctor maybe at some point and to get help that they need. And I'm very happy that I was included in this, as I help him recover through what he needs to recover through and to be more responsible in the future. So you need to be able to also communicate with the person who's coming very effectively.
I don't know what she's saying. I know you hadn't asked me the question, but the question is